And I'll wait for you, baby, you should know. I will follow you anywhere you go. And I'll face the sun and look into your soul. And I'll face the sun and look into your soul. I will follow you anywhere you go. And I'll wait for you, baby, you should know. I will follow.
Yo, what is up? Welcome. I'm trying to change up these intros a little bit. I don't even know what to do. Just the official yo, you know, gotta do the officials. Oh no. What's up, Silly? Welcome back. Two custom comment in code. WTF, bro. Saving up those points, racking up those points to get those comments. Okay, okay. Welcome in. Thanks for being here today, friend. And thank you, everyone else, for joining in. Happy Thursday. Hope, today's Thursday, right? Okay, God. Whoa. For like a quick minute, I thought today was still Wednesday. And I'm like, this has been the longest day of my life. But welcome back, everybody. Hope everyone's week is going well. Hope you're building some cool stuff. Working on some cool stuff. Just having a good week. Hopefully listening to some good music. It's always top tier, especially when you're working on something like Grüvee, you know? But today we are on... Oh, I don't think I changed the day. God damn it. But we are on day... 50, yeah, we're on day 53 of Grüvee development. Yeah, today we're just going right back into Redux. Not really too much to talk about beforehand there, but yeah, I guess just get right into it, right? Silly, my friend, you got to tell me what lines of code you would like this to be on once I get to the editor, which I will be shortly. But let's move over to GitHub real quick and recap on what we did yesterday. Oh, I did change it, man. Gotta believe in myself sometimes, you know? All right, so yesterday, we actually ended up implementing the songs action, redux action. It's kind of weird. Songs action redux action. We need to continue working through cleaning up a lot of the code that basically we were passing that function through a bunch of different components. I think it was like 6 or 7. So today we're going to continue cleaning that up and continue on to remove all the old actions and ways of getting and editing old songs. So we also set up the fetch songs action, which was grabbing all of our songs, which is very, really fantastic. Yo, Kosi, what's up, man? Welcome in. But yeah, so now we have a new Redux action for... fetching playlist or fetching mock playlist, adding a playlist, deleting a playlist, adding a song, and fetching songs. So that's 5 right there. So we're getting into the nitty gritty, and it's good. It's been good so far. So I guess let's continue on, eh? We'll start off from here and keep going. All right, so I have, I was doing a git status to see where we're at. We have a bunch of these files that have been changed. So I want to go through each of them again, clean up all the old song stuff, and go from there. So if we go to our song list view, yesterday we added the add song to playlist and then fetch songs. So we're calling our props, we're mapping them now to fetch songs and add song to playlist. So now that we have those on our props, we can actually remove stuff from the songs list in general. So I'm thinking what we should do is just search for songs list. Kind of see where that went through. Yeah, we're gonna be over here. Yo, New Duck, what's up? Howdy. Welcome in. Some parts off with some scissors. Yeah, show song list action. That's in the playlist item. And so we already... Oh, do we? Show song list action. This navigates to the song list nav. Okay, so we do take in our playlist data. We do need the playlist ID, but we don't need the songs anymore. We remove the songs. Not much. Also programming? Hey, love it, man. What are you working on? Give me the dirty deets. Yeah, so playlist item. We remove that there. I guess look for song list in here as well. Nice, only those two. So at that point, we're going to actually then navigate over to the song list nav. So that's going to be this guy here. And so at this point, songs is actually correct because that's what we're mapping our prop to. What VS Code theme is that? So this is actually Adam One Dark. This guy right here. Yeah, this one's pretty sick. I use this one here, and at work I use the Dracula theme. It's actually fantastic. Yeah, this is it, friend. What about that gives information on chemistry formulas? Ooh, dude, that's sick. Are you in a university by any chance? That's probably a great university tool for your fellow students. Dracula theme number one. Hey, James, welcome back, man. Nice to see you. Yeah, Dracula theme is pretty lit. I like it a lot. I kind of want to use it on my machine at home. Nice, New Duck. That's sick, man. I'm younger than that. Hey, there we go. Awesome. Awesome. Hey, Gammon, welcome in. Well, that sounds like a great tool, dude. Get that shit done. All right, so we had songs, fetch songs, add playlists. And then at this point, add song to playlist. That's cool. So that calls our dispatcher. What are these guys? Oh, those things there. We're going to have to clean those up. That's fine. Is that really it? I thought there was a lot more, but I guess that makes sense. Let's go to the playlist view. Let's go to song list here. I think we cleaned up our action in here. This is where we were originally passing it from. Yeah, so we would have had it here. Anything here? Nah, no song list stuff here. Yeah, this one would have had playlist, delete song from playlist, update song and playlist. So when we change those actions, we'll have to do it. Oh, so I pull playlist item. We can actually remove this now. Yes. The UI is pretty good in my opinion. Hey, nice. Hell yeah. Material design inspired. I think material design's a great platform. They got some good stuff. Overall, it's a nice UI to build with. That variant has Dracula and One Dark Pro. Oh baby. Oh, that reminds me. Every time you come in chat, James, I always forget that I don't have my chat open over here. You always post these useful links, man. All right. So now that that's there, I think we are good to go. So let's commit this stuff first. And then we'll go ahead, build the app, make sure it's still working. Give a little demo of what's going on there. And then continue on. Hey, thanks, dude. You already knew. Oh, that's pretty sick. Ooh. I'm liking that. Ooh. Ooh. Oh, nice, New Duck. Honestly, sometimes that's just the way to do it. He's committing. Oh, Gammon, dude. My chat trolled me for the longest time. They're like, you literally haven't committed for 5 days. Are you sure that your computer's not going to explode and you're going to lose all your work? So I've been accustomed to it from the bullying from chat. Hey, New Dog, thank you so much for the follow, friend. Welcome to the Pixelogic team. Glad to have you, friend. Hey, and Gammon1125. Thank you so much for the follow as well. Welcome to the freaking time. Boom. Yo, stacking? Yeah, dude, never. Never would ever troll me, ever. Oh, so mock playlist we can take out as well here. So I'm just going to go through, check to make sure that our changes are what we wanted. And we'll go from there. Yeah, that was what we expected. Playlist item. Here we changed. We removed the old songs prop that we're passing in because we don't need to pass in anymore since we're fetching it. Yeah, same thing here. Passing, just removing the pass along and swipeable playlist item. Oh, add song to playlist. Yep, we can remove this guy. And then this was the songs, right? Yeah, add song to playlist action we can remove since we don't need to pass that through any longer. Same there. Nice. Latest changes. That's cool, Nuduck. You should consider putting some metrics in your site. If you have not yet, to see like how people are using it. That's always a great way to improve on stuff, right? All right, and here we're calling fetch songs. Song comment is defined but never used. Okay, see ya, dude. And then at this point, song from lib, cool. Yeah, here we change songs, fetch songs, and add songs to playlist. And then use effect. We're going to go ahead and fetch our songs. What did I remove here? Oh, I just removed a comment. Okay. Then we create our new song. When the person presses submit, we run our add song to playlist dispatch. And then after that is done, we're actually going to run fetch songs. And now I think about it, it's probably going to need to be... Yeah. Well, this would be this guy here. We'll probably need to do this asynchronously if we're going to be doing... It's probably a network call or something along these lines. So this is going to change because right now, since we're just using mock data, we could just grab it straight from memory, but we're going to have to figure out how we're going to structure that. Google Analytics OP 100%. Exactly. Yeah. It's just because you have analytics doesn't mean you have to take people's info. It's more along the lines of like who clicked here or what did they click? Like what pages did they visit? Maybe like what chemistry equations they were trying to look at. That stuff always helps, but you don't have to collect people's data to do that. You just literally log a click. All right. And then what else did we change down here? We just added our action creators for add song to playlist and fetch songs, map state to props, map dispatch to props, and our connect. Boom skis. So our song list view and action type is next. Yo, TNAP, what's up? Thank you so much for the follow. Welcome to the PixelLogic team. Glad to have you here. Oh, this is what I wanted to do. Add mock data. I wanted to change this to fetch mock data. Because it made more sense. It's their clicks? Ah, no, it is their clicks. Yeah, I mean, it was just a thought, you know, something that you might want to consider because it is very important. Or like it's good practice for real world scenarios as well. If you plan on doing something like that. Okay, so add mock data, we're going to say fetch mock data is going to be the new name of this guy. Yeah, I think that should be it. Wait, what? Isn't this the replace? Oh, I had to press enter first. That was really weird. I feel like I've never had to do that before. All right. Yeah, I really wanted to change that. Since we started using fetch songs down here, it made sense to fetch mock data. All right. And then let's commit this guy. Are we on to the next one? Git add, git commit, adding redux state for songs and songs list. Whoa. Actual commit messages, let's go. Yo, I just gotta say, we do it real here. We do it real here with the commits. I don't know why I had to change, but we did. All right, so now, since we did that, let's go ahead and move over to the next action that we're gonna be dealing with, which will be playlist view. The next one shall be delete song from playlist. So now we're going to make a delete action for our songs. So first, let's go over to our action type. And so now we have, want to do this here. So the export, we're going to give it an action name. Delete song from playlist. Oh, actually, I was going to make sure that the app is still running, right? That's what we should do. So npm run start, and then npm run iOS start. Let's get that, and then I can show you guys for the new peeps up in here. All right, so this is Grüvee. And I'm gonna throw this over here. My remote debugger. And so right now, the way that we are tracking Redux is just through logs. Logs in the console. We have a middleware logger that we set up a bit ago. So, essentially, this is it. You're going to go ahead, log in with something. Again, this is all mocked right now, so it's technically not officially working. Oh, crap. Well, hold on. I just missed the log. But as soon as you get in here, you'll see that we received our first action of fetch mock data, which, cool, the name change did persist. And we get our list of playlists. So your playlist can have a name, X amount of members, and then it'll tell you the number of songs. So we'll go to your boy Alex playlist, and you'll see through here we're actually going to run another Redux action called fetch songs, which then we grab the songs for that playlist specifically, render it to the screen, and boom, we're good. And so in here you're actually able to deep link into a current song. So I think maybe this one has a deep link. So this will open in Spotify. The cool thing is that the game plan is to have the ability for anyone to be able to use any streaming service, which is super cool. And so based on the setup that you'll go through, you'll specify your preferred service, and then I'll only feed you the songs with the deep links appropriate to your service. Yeah, this is just a wrapper for the links there. And then you can actually go to comments, and then you can talk about the song. And so at this point, we have the ability now to only delete, obviously, your comments. There's no reply feature, like, in, I guess, per section. You know, per thread is a better way to describe it. But yeah, so all this right now is being used, and we're setting this all up with Redux, which is good. So this is, yeah, this is the app. And so if we do an add song, some song link, and all you do is add the link of the song, and then you could decide to add a comment, add. And so it, I have a default song in there for Spotify, but this will open up, and then the link is broken, right? It's not a real link, so I just go unable to open song, and that's it. Hey, I'm Connor, what's up? This is React Native, yes. No, right now it doesn't. What the fuck is light mode? 100%. Yeah, right now it's just all dark mode. It's funny, I just like, I naturally go towards the design of dark mode apps, and so all my apps usually just start off in dark mode, and that's it. But yeah, so that's the app. Looks like everything's working, so let's continue on to our next action here again. So we are doing export const delete songs from playlist, creating our Redux action here. And then we'll need to add this also to our reducer. We're out of time and I can't breathe. I told you not to believe me. Okay, so at this point, we're going to return our state. I might have to separate this out. It's getting pretty long there. I went more down the Vue.js route, and their native feature is a bit of a mess. This looks like quite simply to use compared to with React itself. Yeah, so I've done a lot of native iOS development, and so this has definitely been a nice change to now be able to write just JS code and then have it just work for Android and iOS. Obviously there's caveats. The biggest thing I've been running into is the navigation library that we've been using called React Native Navigation. It has a lot of, chokeholds at the moment where it just doesn't work as you would want or expect. But yeah, it's great, man. I would highly recommend it. Pain to set up? No, it's very easy. You can use literally like, I think they have a starter project that you can just clone from GitHub, and that's it. The only thing is, I would say if you've never done any sort of native development for Android or iOS, it's kind of, I think there's going to be a learning curve there to understand these things called like a view instead of a div or a page. And just how like the stack of a navigation or a mobile app works for sure. JS greater than PHP, VS Code greater than Vim. Damn! James, drop in the truth. What about Angular though? What's up, Estrange? Angular, you know? That's all I gotta say. Or, weirdly. Alright, and so here, we're just gonna actually comment this out for now. But this will, when we hit delete song from playlist, we'll return our state. Then our thing here, and share from there. It's cool because I already have this logic set up essentially. I just need to actually implement Redux. I have too many of these. Yo, silly, tell me what line, man. If you don't have a preference, I'll put it somewhere. Yeah. So here, delete song from playlist. At this point, yeah, so we pass this down. Let's see, so I will play this item. They pretty much all take the same path, right? Which is what I was doing, is I was passing the action down to this component. Swipeable playlist item. Delete from playlist action, pass that down to our playlist item itself. And then, yeah, so we can do this essentially in the same section here, which I thought we'd do in our song list view. because we're actually passing this all the way down here. So we just actually add this action into our songs list view. Are you using the Spotify API for anything, or is it just a wrapper for links? It's literally just a deep link, which is freaking awesome. So essentially, I ask for you to add a new song. You post the link in there, and currently right now it doesn't do anything other than wrap it like you're saying. But what you get for free is you get the deep link into applications, which is really cool. So if you have the app installed on your phone, it will open up Spotify to the song immediately, else it'll open in the web. But what I'm going to do is, let's say you post a song where me and you are on a playlist together and you listen to Apple Music and I listen to Spotify. So my Spotify link will go up to a function in the cloud. Jesus Christ. I gotta make this point thing higher. Holy crap. But it'll go up to a service that will essentially say, hey, let me use Apple's Apple Music API to see if this song exists on Apple Music. Convert it to the Apple Music link and send it back down to you so you can access it directly through Apple Music. That's kind of the cool thing that I'm really excited to work on. Yeah. It's essentially just like an aggregator for every song that you can list and see if it exists in different platforms. And so you don't have to worry about, oh shit, it's on Spotify. You know, it's like, you listen to Apple Music. All right. Let me add these comments. Man, you guys are just holding back on me this whole time, huh? God damn it. What's today? 0130? Just do this. This is one of the ways you can use your pixel points. If you're curious, get a comment embedded in code immediately, anywhere in the app. And then when the PRs come through, you're going to be like, what in the heck is this? My code now. When do you get a chance to add JavaScript from channel points? Oh no. That sounds so dangerous. I don't know if you heard about GOG, but you're basically doing the same thing just with Falling Soda Games. I have heard of GOG. Dude, I remember following that project a while back, and I was so excited for it. I was like, yo, finally someone's coming out with something like this. Like, this is exactly what we need, because I don't know. It's a mess right now with all these freaking installers and stuff. But yeah, that'd be a cool way to do it. The biggest thing is I do this with my friend a lot, and this is like a pain point for me in music. I love sharing music, and I love talking about it with people I share it with. So I'll send him a song through iMessage. He'll open it up. He'll listen to it. He comes back to iMessage, talks to me about it, and then that conversation, that thread is gone, right? And then it's only between me and him. So I tried doing a Spotify collaborative playlist. And at that point, I hated it because I don't get any notifications. So like at the very simplest thing, I wanted an app that gave me a notification when someone added a song and allowed me to comment inline. That's it. And then I'm like, if I want this, I'm sure there's other people in the world that want this. So here we are. Yeah, thanks, Gavin. Appreciate it. I'm glad you see it. I like music a lot. Become an Easter egg? I don't know. I gotta get more creative with some of these points, though. Now, I might have to do the comment thing to, like, 1,500 points. Like, people are just racking them up. I like it, though. I like it a lot. And since this is open source, like, I cannot wait for people to come by and be like, what the heck is this? Like, why are all these things here? All right, so we have our plan. Let's go ahead and... let's do it. So we have delete songs from playlist. Or delete song from playlist. Delete song from playlist. So now all we need to do is add our action creator here. So add song to playlist. Essentially, it's literally just this. Except we're going to call this delete song from glasses. Awesome. So we need the playlist ID and we're going to need the song ID. Because what we're going to do is we're going to find the playlist it's a part of. Then we're going to go in there and just filter out the song. And so all we'll need for that. Yeah, this will be an easy one. We'll pass in our playlist ID. We'll pass in our song ID. Oh, so song? What? and then, yes, that'll be our action creator. And at this point, then we just need to map that here. So delete song from playlist. Again, we'll pass in our playlist ID and our song ID. And then we will just dispatch that. Dispatch our action creator, which is delete song from playlist, passing in our playlist ID and our song ID. I have some syntax issues here. Delete song from playlist. Probably missed a paren. No. Oh, a comma. Cool. And then here, what we'll do is since we're mapping that to our props, we'll also just do add song to fetch songs, add song, boom. And then this guy is what we shall remove. And that's it. So this is where our new action will be going. Which is sweet. Heck yeah, buddy. If people tune on a streak, they get a bonus. They do. Yeah, that's true. Yeah, I'll have to add some more. I like that people are using it. I think the point stuff that Twitch offered is really cool. Especially if you have some like the default ones are pretty good, I would say, to begin with. But custom ones for the channel. The gift things you can click from time to time. Oh, wow. Wow, someone made an extension for that? That is lit. Yeah, dude, James, that's actually so funny because I was literally thinking about that one. I do have some hue bulbs. I actually use them in my room. So I might just have to take them out, put them in here, and be like, well. Or buy LED matrix. Dude, can you hook me up with the LED matrix? How much will it be? I'm going to save up for a disco party. Yeah, maybe like you save up for light show and disco party. You're writing a guide for it? Heck yeah, dude. Send it my way. All right, so at this point, we will delete song. So this guy will be down here. We'll call this thing. Delete song from playlist. We need to pass in playlist ID and song ID. Oh, right. Okay, so where is this thing going? I guess it's the question. I don't even need this function anymore. I do because I have to. No, I don't. I can just literally do filter out from current state. Yeah, this is literally the action that we're going to do. Yeah, we can actually just call this and remove this thing altogether. So why don't we do that? But we'll need to pass in play. Oh no, we already have access to playlist ID. And then it's item.id. Yeah, we can literally just do that. Delete song from playlist, which will give us the ability to remove this thing. Open source my TypeScriptlet, which lets you remote render to it from Electron node. Oh, sweet. That's awesome, man. Heck yeah, I'm gonna have to put a stream goal to buy those guys. That's cool, man. That was a really cool project you did. I liked it a lot. Wait, why was that there? Oh. Okay, cool. So that should be good. We can remove this. And then... yeah, we'll just do that. So now, we need to set up our action to do something. Oh, we actually may need to use this. Now I think about it, because we need a way to fetch our songs again. We had to do that up here. After we added our song, we actually had to call fetch to grab the latest. Yeah, probably we'll need to do that. But okay, let's at least get this going, and then we can change that up. So playlist, I'm going to go then to this thing called playlist actions that I created. Oh, damn, this song's a banger. Classic. I know exactly what goes on. So at this point, we can do... I'm going to put some spaces in between these. Export const. Delete song from playlist. On the trigger. Or we take our current playlist... we'll pass in our playlist ID, and we'll pass in our song ID. You tell all your friends, you've got your gun to my head. And literally, we are just doing this, so... and we were playing around yesterday a lot with this thing. Which essentially was, we would find the playlist. So in this instance, we're going to have to find the playlist. Then we're going to have to filter, find the playlist, get the songs. Then out of that, filter out the songs, which we'll need to return the playlist or return the array of songs. Then we'll have to set that back onto the playlist. Yes. Right? Does that make sense? Yeah, so I think for this we might have to do it in two goes. Yeah, so maybe what we should do... This is what I always run into. It's like... we would say something like const playlist equals current playlist dot find p dot... ID is equal to playlist ID. That returns our playlist, right? And then at this point, I would want to do something like... filtered songs. and I would do something like playlist.songs.filter, and I would say at this point playlist songs filter this thing. So it'd be song, and then song.id does not equal ID. Yeah, so return all the songs that do not equal this ID. And so that would give us a new array of filtered songs. Hey, Emorks, almost enough for a custom call-in? Let's go! Heck yeah, dude. What's up, my man? How's it going today? And so now I have my array of filtered songs, but now I need to... It was this thing, right? Yeah. So then I can return the playlist and then just set the songs. That's what it was. Okay. Yes. Frankie Bows. Howdy ho there, neighbor. Welcome to the Pixel Logic team. Glad to have you here, my friend. Yeah, good. Thanks, you. Good, man. Glad to see it. Yeah. Things are going, man. Things are going. And then songs. So filtered songs. That's what it was. Yeah. So at this point, again, grab the playlist that the song's a part of. Filter out all the songs that don't equal the song we need to delete, meaning removing the song. Then we're going to return the spread of our playlist, all the props in there. And then the songs will just be our filtered songs. And that's it. How's the new place? Dude, the new place is awesome. It's been really cool. Yeah, thanks for asking. It's pretty insane to me that that not having my computer set up in my room is helping me sleep better, I think. It's like that weird separation. Having like all of this just in another room is great. I don't know if any of you guys are on my Instagram. You know, you should do a little follow there. You know what I'm saying? If you're interested and got Instagram and you want to see what happens behind the scenes of life and stuff. I actually got a new guitar a couple weeks ago. And, dude, I got my amp yesterday and holy crap. So happy. So happy. Oh, man. I haven't played guitar in forever. Yeah, man. I got a 7-string Ibanez. Yeah, this thing is pretty sick. Pretty sick. Play some chords sometime. You know, I was thinking about that yesterday. I was like, I'm trying to learn this album from this band called August Burns Red. And I was like, maybe just, I practice it every day. And it's like, it's going to take a long time. So I was like, maybe on stream I could do it one day. I don't know, though. It's just, it's a lot of repetition, right? So here we're going to do state.playlist. Actually, I can grab it. I'll show it to you guys. Action.data.playlist ID and then action.data.song ID. Sweet. I was looking at my ancient sketcher. It's bad shape. Oh, no. Sorry, dude. Want to get a 7-string? Yeah, man. I used to play for a while. I think I was pretty mediocre, but now I'm trying to, like, get good. Why do you all play instruments? Bro, instruments are so... Music is incredible. It's just freaking awesome. I love it. I teach trombone? Oh, really? Dude, that's actually really sick. All right, let me grab it real quick. I'll show you to you guys. So this is it. This is pretty cool. Yeah, This is a, it's a great, it's the RG series, if you guys know anything about that stuff. Yeah, it's this nice, like, sunburnt orange. I think it's called, like, Dragon Scale or something like that. But, yes, seven strings. So, now slam it on this floor. Nah, man. Not yet. Maybe the goal is to join a band here in Seattle. I'm going to play one live show, get people moshing, and then I'll slam it, because then my career as a guitarist will be over. Yeah, we'll do, James, we'll do. Yo, Yumorks, can you teach me some trombone? That's a pretty dope instrument. Oh my god, that would be the ultimate freaking stream right there. That would sound terrible. It would sound terrible. Oh my god. I love it though. Great idea. Alright, so we have our delete song from playlist action, mapping our state. Our playlist is then going to be delete song from playlist. We're passing in our playlist ID, our song ID. Playlist ID, song ID. We're doing our stuff here. Boom shakalaka. It should work. The only thing that won't work is probably the... I don't think the view is going to re-render, so we're going to have to add that in a second. But I want to see if we're actually logging the action. At least, let's start. Run tart. No. Let's start. I don't need this. Let's see it, friends. I once played an FPS game with Guitar Hero controller. Oh, nice, man. Dude, that's another game I love. I have Rock Band for the Wii. Like the full drums and guitar and all that stuff. That game is so fun. Actually, probably a couple of years ago, I did a Clone Hero stream. One night. It was a lot of fun. I love it. What game was it, James, that you played? Alright, so we're going to go in, we're going to delete a song. So what we're looking for is our action to log here. Oh, that's a comment. It's not a song. So to delete, you just do a little slide. Delete. Oh no! Oh my god! So our action did get called. And it looks like our playlist ID and our song ID. Cool. And so, our playlist should now include... I don't remember what song it was. Oh yeah, there we go. It now has two songs. So, that's that, which is great. But we did get an error. Somewhere. Try to get frame for out of range index. Okay. So, it looks like it was trying to access... Potentially trying to access it again somewhere? Oh, and CSGO? God damn. That must have been great. Oh my god. Do you have a video, Emorks? That's crazy, dude. Okay, let's see what delete song from playlist action is doing as well over here. This is where we defined it, right? So, playlist, if playlist ID was playlist, playlist.song, playlist.filter, song ID, song, and then return playlist, and then just set playlist. Okay, so that's essentially what we're doing. Hmm. Why would it be doing that? Because it looks like the action went through, which is good. And we pass our array back of filtered songs. Did I forget something here in the reducer? I don't think so. Playlist, delete song from playlist. Hold on. I want to try one more time. I want to see if I can catch anything that I didn't see. So cool kids music. It's only for this to reload. Delete. And if I press cancel, it should be good. Nice. Okay. Okay. Where can I? Oh. Yeah, I was gonna say, where's my stack trace? I guess it's right here. So it's coming from playlist. Oh, from playlist view. Playlist view created by Connect, and then at playlist view 137 in the flat list. Swipe list view. But why playlist view? Oh, it was ages ago. I could remake it. Do it. Oh, CSGO on the LED desk? That's crazy, dude. That sounds awesome, though. But it looks like it's the flat list for the swipe list view, which is weird. But let's go over to the swipe list. Oh, the swipe list view is, well, if we look at the error again, it's playlist view and then at line 137. Yeah, so this guy, we take in our playlist content container style, shows a vertical scroll, key extractor, render item. Playlist data is the item we pass in. Yeah. Delete. Oh, is it this? Did I already remove it? No, I don't think I already deleted it. No. Oh, I'm going to comment this out and we're going to see. I don't think this is it, but it potentially could be. It potentially could be. Doubtful, but it could be. Image recognition is so cool, man. I did it for a little bit on Apex, but using OCR, I just wasn't really having a good time, or like it was very difficult. For some reason, there was something I didn't understand. Are we trying to create a parser for files in Swift? Oh yeah, yeah, dude. I saw your comment this morning. Yeah, when I woke up. Hey, Draco, what's up? Welcome. All right, so let's try this again. I won't delete you. Nah. I didn't think that was it, but it was worth a try. I don't know why this is, it's weird because the error is showing it's in the playlist view, but we're not in the playlist view. We're in the song list view, so I would expect it to be here. Right?
call. I've been hearing silence on the other side for way too long. I can taste it on my tongue. I can tell that something's wrong, but I guess it's just my life, and I can take it if I wanna. But I cannot hide in hills of California, because these hills have eyes, and I got.
So if it's trying, it was trying to re-render the cells at, it must be trying to re-render the cells at that point, right? I wish I could see more of a trace. Because literally from this point, or sorry, this point to delete, I guess let me take a look at that delete. I think I might have missed one step in this when I press delete. So in the song list view, we do delete song from playlist. And swipeable song item. Let's go there. Swipeable song item. I couldn't OBS plugin that reads the kill count from Fortnite and starts to play meme 10 seconds before I get a kill on stream. Dude, that was literally what I was trying to do. Something very similar to music. It was, you'd be able to set certain songs for the amount of people left alive in a match. So if you're in like a top 10 situation, it would read the kill count for the game, and then you could set like some like hype song or some epic like final stand song or whatever. But I couldn't get the OCR to work with the kill count in with Apex. I don't know why. Just couldn't do it. Okay, so we have delete item by ID is what we're looking at here. So swipe action callback is where that's being used. Which makes sense. So on the animated swipe row, we do this thing. We do swipe action callback.
Oh my god.
Oh! Woo! My god! Tim! Back? Tim's back? Let's go! Tim is back for another massive, massive raid. Thank you so much for the 34 fresh new devs. Holy moly. Yo, huge, huge shout out to Tim. I think everyone here should know Tim by now. But if you don't, go check him out. Awesome game dev streamer. Appreciate that so much, man. How was your stream? Hope it went well. Yo, Reme, what's up? Welcome in. What's up, Gear? Welcome, welcome. For everyone's new, hey, what's up? Welcome to the channel. My name's Alec. I work on a social collaborative playlist app for iOS and Android called Grüvee, currently being built in React Native. And currently, we are implementing Redux throughout the app. And if you don't know what Redux is just state management for the application. In a more global sense, that can be managed in a much better way. Partial Data, thank you so much for the follow, man. Welcome to the Pixelogic team. Glad to have you here. I must run for work now. Enjoy the turtle. Sorry to run. Nah, you good, man. Appreciate you so much, Tim. Thank you again for that incredible raid. You rock, dude. Have a great day at work. Peace. All right. So we're running into an issue now where we just set up our Redux action to delete a song from a playlist. But we're getting a re-render error, and I'm trying to track it down, but I don't see it. I don't see it here. Swipeable song item. Yo, Reme be good, and Nesby one. Thank you very much for the follows, friends. Welcome to the team. Glad to have you here. Yeah, so our songs, that should be good. Playlist ID songs, fetch songs, add songs, delete. And so when I do animated swipe row, swipe action callback. So let's go to our animated swipe row component. Let's see if we can find anything there. Maybe so. This is cool. I'm starting to do React for work. Hey, nice, Partial. Yeah, it's a lot of fun. I've been really enjoying it, and I've been learning a lot too. But what are you doing for work? What type of app are you all building? So we have this thing here. So I pass in the swipe animated swipe row, swipe action callback. Yeah, that's what it's called. So this thing, right? And this essentially do swipe ref dot current and swipe ref current manually swipe row. Because we run a little animation when we actually do the delete. Swipe action callback. His last item. Ooh, this component is actually not very reusable because this is called the animated swipe row. But the only action I have right now is delete. So I've literally catered this to only be for a delete. So we're gonna have to change this one day when we add more actions, but for now it's good. It's web front and not native. I do the APIs using C#.NET Core, but sometimes I get to do some React work. Hey, nice. Hell yeah. That's awesome. That is awesome, man. Yeah, React is fun. It's nice to go from C# to JavaScript and or TypeScript every so often. For sure. So what is this exactly though? It looks like it goes through the entire animation, right? Which is good. I think I know what this means, but let's just put it in Google and double check. Like I can understand what it's saying, but we should double check it. I miss streaming feels bad, man. Oh, yeah, dude, I missed it too. You should stream, dude. Put in the grind. I wrote Angular for 2 years using Swift, and now I'm doing React.js, so it's just a bit of a mind wrap. Yeah, I didn't write Angular for that long, but I did a project where I worked on Angular for a bit. React is so much better, man. I used to think the other way around, and then I was like, nah, I was crazy. Oh, with your internet, right. Oh, sorry, dude. Yeah. I wasn't giving data an array. Oh. Oh! Is that what it is? Am I not actually sending back an array with my songs? No, I am. An array of songs. God damn it. I thought that was it. That would have been a good one. I was actually stream program at 800 kilobits. Damn. That's actually pretty great, man. Yeah, so that is that. I wonder if we can, because I am passing it back, because maybe in my reducer I'm not properly passing it back. Where are you? I probably need to log my state. That's what we probably need to do after Yeah. All right. So let's do this thing here. We can remove this. And then, so delete song from playlist. Yeah, and see what we get after we do this. So delete song from playlist with playlist ID. Let's call it song ID, please. Yes, thank you. Delete item, and then we'll call this delete song from playlist action. I always call this delete song. And then down here, we'll do delete song. Okay. And then after we call the Redux action, we'll go ahead and do a console.log of songs. We'll make sure it's an array. It might, because in the action it prints out an array, but it might not be coming back as an array. That's actually pretty great. Off to save bits, yeah. Yeah, dude, that's the way to do it, man. Just try it out. Hey, you want to kill this up, dude? Hell yeah, man. Tim came by, rated us with a nice 34 new devs. Heck yeah, bro. All right, so again, we're going to check this out. Go here. Just remove this crap. Delete the first song. Delete. Okay, so at this point, yeah, no, our songs come back as an array of songs. So that makes sense. So at least we know we're getting the proper data back. Again, the error, though, is in the playlist view. So we should go to the playlist view and potentially log the same thing for some reason or not. The other thing I can check as well before we do that is the reducer to make sure I set playlists. State I did playlists, right? I'm very prone for spelling errors, so yeah. Yeah, and the state comes back. Oh! It doesn't, right here. The reducer is actually returning an array with only one playlist. Oh. Woo. Jesus. How many Grammys did some cool new song win? Hey. Many, many. You just haven't heard of them yet. They've already run Grammys and they haven't even been played for the public. All right, so you guys see that here? This is literally what the issue was. I was returning playlists, but I'm returning an object there for some weird reason. Or the, I did this yesterday as well. I know why. I should be returning, when I map this, I did the songs there. Oh, because I'm just, oh man. God damn it. Okay. So we actually need to return play lists like this, and it's going to be array of current playlists. Oh no. Playlists, and then sounds about right. Yeah. Pepe. So I figure out how to properly return this. Yo, hi technical. Hi tech. Thank you very much for the follow. Welcome to the Pixelogic team. Glad to have you here, friend. An array playlist? Yeah, so the only issue is I think I know what it is. I think I know how we can do this. Something similar to that. Gotta go to sleep. See ya, Yimorks. I hope tomorrow you have enough points to, you know, add that custom comment. Enough pixels. Have a good night, man. Thanks for stopping by. I will catch you later. Yeah, what we need to do is Because essentially, we have the filtered songs, and now I need to set the filtered songs on the playlist. Right? And so, this playlist, then I would need to overwrite the current playlist in this list. So we can do what I did actually yesterday with... I start off with a slice. I was trying to go through this method, but I don't... Wait, how did this work? Oh, because they did a map. Yeah. Oh, okay. I need to do a map. Because with the map, we'll always just return... We'll return the playlist back that hasn't been altered. That's what it was. Okay. So we can still do this. We just need to... do it like this. So we return current playlist.map. I want this out. That's literally, I did this yesterday and I've already forgotten how to do it. We get the playlist. We say if the playlist ID is equal to the playlist ID passed in, we're going to then filter, get our filtered songs. So filtered song equals the playlist.songs.filter. With that logic, and then at this point, we're going to return this, like that. Else, we're just gonna return a playlist, whatever the OG playlist is. Yeah, heck yeah, that works. That should work. And then that hopefully will get rid of our error. And then we can take a look-see. All right, let's test it. Almost first try? Semi first try? Yo, Copper Beardy, welcome in, man. Nice to see ya. So we're gonna go here, delete this guy. Nice. So the only problem is, since we aren't fetching the songs again after you do the delete, you'll see that our array still shows up as 3. nothing has changed. So, since our songs hasn't changed, we gotta fetch. We gotta fetch. Pop dad stack. Bah. Oh. Pop it real good. All right, let's go. Oh, did I? I don't know why that wasn't saved, but let's double check that real quick. Let's double check this guy real quick. Yeah. Okay, cool. I thought the same thing would happen, but you never know. So songless view. So at this point, delete songs. Set songs to display. Again, fetch songs. Because our Redux state is good to go, but not our local state. People are popping without me? Stacking, bro. Come on, man. Where have you been? Glansk, thank you so much for the follow, friend. Welcome to the Pixelogic team. Glad to have you here. All right. First try, right? Hello? Hello? Did it work, though? Did it say... Oh. It didn't work. Oh, no. Gasp. I really thought that was going to be it. Oh, no. Oh, no. Gasp. Glad to be here. I'm new and I'm 5 minutes already hooked. Hey, awesome, Glance. I appreciate you being here and I'm glad you think so. Yeah, welcome to the community, dude. This is how the streams usually are. Gammon. What did I do wrong? Okay, so delete song. We call our action. Right? Unless it didn't actually delete it. Did it? Did it delete it? We'll check in our playlist. Oh. Oh, wait, what? Fetch songs. Songs came back as three. Playlists still had three songs. It looks like our action didn't actually actionably work. So let's take a look. I think it probably has to do with the reducer logic here. All right, one more time. One more time. We got this. Current playlist map. If the playlist ID is equal to the playlist that we're looking for, let's go into our next piece of logic. From that playlist, we grab the songs and we're going to filter out. We're going to filter out the song ID. Yeah. Or we're going to return every song that doesn't equal to the ID that we want to delete. Right? So that makes sense. That should remove the song. And then at this point, we're going to return that playlist data. And then our song with our filtered songs, which should be our array. Yeah, that looks right. That looks good. And then I guess let's do this. And we'll add a log statement after the map is done. Let's not log. Excuse me. New playlist. Let's take a look here. Is filter really working? Like, it filters not sure song has correct value. Yeah. Yeah, that's true, man. That's what we're going to figure out right now. Essentially, after I go through the map, I'm just going to log out what our new playlist array should be. And at that point, yeah, we'll double check to see that that's correct. For sure. So we delete that. Okay, here. This is delete song from playlist. Then we log, and then it logs our next. So we have our three arrays. And songs. Yeah, okay. So there we go. You're probably right, high tech. The song was not filtered out correctly, which means either the playlist ID is incorrect, or the filter's not actually working. So before we log here, let's go back to the songlist view itself and make sure we're properly passing in the right data. So delete song, delete item by ID. Playlist ID is part of our props, so that's fine there. And then item.id would be our song. So that looks good. Is there anything there that I'm missing? Oh, I think I know why. Technically, this is not correct, right? No, it should be. Because this would throw an error. I was going to say this anonymous function probably needs the props passed in here, right? And then we can pass them into our delete song action. But it doesn't matter. It's anonymous, right? It's just going to run whatever's inside of it. So that does look correct. So we should now check to see what playlist ID is and the other ID is. Yeah, let's just log this real quick. And then if it's incorrect for some reason, then we can backtrack and see why it's not working. So playlist ID, song ID. We know that new playlist. Actually, let's comment this out. Actually, no, we don't need that at all. All right. Debugging 101. Log statements are life. Our life. First song, What? Did I type? Oh, they're the same. What the heck? Yeah. So it'd be, there's six songs. So it'd be 1, 2, 3. They're the same. That's why it's not working. So let's go to delete from playlist in our reducer. So playlist ID and song ID. So that looks okay. So if it's on action data, that means that's coming from our songlist view. Remember when everyone was questioning React Native yesterday? Shopify just published a blog post saying they think it's the future and they're all in. Oh, snap. Yeah, dude. Well, that, so the article they were referencing yesterday in regards to Airbnb, that was like when React Native, I don't think it was fairly new, but it was pretty close to being fairly new, which I find interesting. But yeah, that's crazy, dude. All right, playlist ID, song ID, dispatch, delete from playlist. So again, yeah, playlist ID and song ID. So it would be delete song. Render item. I guess let's go to this thing. This is weird. Song item. But where? What's getting passed into this thing? It's the data, the songs. Huh. Yeah, thanks for that stacking. Yeah, dude, this is weird. We are passing in the songs prop, and it is mapping correctly. State, playlist, data, reducer, songs. And we can also see that in our action here. We have our songs, song 0, 1, and 2. But in our reducer, or I'm sorry, in our actual action, playlist ID is still coming back. Playlist ID is correct. But song ID, okay, so I guess now the next kind of log point is to actually see, is our songlist view getting the correct data, or is there an issue with the fetch? That looks okay. Playlist ID, song ID. Yeah, so it would make sense that if this isn't working here. So we'll do playlist ID, and then song ID. Oh, I know what the issue is. Dude, oh man. No. All right, delete song. Delete song. Hold on. Delete song takes in one parameter, song ID. The one parameter I'm passing in first is the playlist ID. So obviously it's going to be playlist ID. Oh, that's too trippy. It's because playlist ID is a prop that I've passed in. Oh, man. God damn, that's a good one. That is a good one, Alec. I knew it had to be something dumb like that. So it should just be this. And now, this should work. I'm gonna take a little sip of water. Man. Honestly, that was a pretty good debug sesh. I think we did that very efficiently. There it is. There it is. So now you can see. Yeah, here we go. No songs. And if we come out here, we should have two. We do. Woo. Let's go. And people still bash static typing. Yeah, I don't know why, man. Yeah. I mean, in all honesty, I should be using TypeScript. I don't know why I chose to do this in JS. TypeScript, I mean, it wouldn't have helped in that scenario, but could have maybe helped a little bit. Hey, Nictius and SMDS, thank you so much for the follows. Welcome to the Pixelotic team, my friends. Thank you for being here. Thank you for being here. Just want to give a little shout out to the Discord server real quick. If any of you are new in here, you're looking for some programming help, want to showcase some projects, and just be a part of a community with a bunch of different devs, Pixelogic team, come join the Discord. Love to have you in there. And take a look at my Instagram as well. I've been posting stuff outside of the stream. Things that go on behind the scenes of setting things up, as well as just kind of a daily life of a software engineer at a tech company. If you're interested in that stuff, give those things a follow. We'd love to have you part of there and be part of the community. Hey, Ryonic, TypeScript, yeah. I don't know why I didn't choose it this time. Really bad move on my part. But cool, so now we have our delete song action set up. So now let's go back and make sure we've cleaned up all the crap from that we were passing in from the playlist view. Like, delete song from playlist action. Ooh, this is so satisfying right here. Bop. Get out of here. Let's go. Awesome. So we delete that, and now we probably get some errors somewhere. Yes, this thing. Delete song from playlist action. So we can remove that. Folks, we are so close to removing all these actions. Like, I'm pretty excited. Playlist data. And then we'll move over. That was into swipeable playlist item. We can remove that. And then that's probably going to give us an error. No. Remove that. Where else do we got you? Here it is. Yes. And then one more. Render playlist item. Bye bye. Awesome. And so then we go to our playlist item. Same deal. Get all this stuff out of here because we don't need to pass it through anymore. Yeah, so you can see just how deep these props went down. Literally, we have a playlist view that has a swipeable playlist item that has a playlist item inside of it. And I had to pass all of these down just so when I tap on a playlist item, it would navigate to the list of songs. So that's about four different components we had to go through just for the delete action of a playlist item. So Redux is coming in quite clutch right now. I think that... Oh, no. Yes, yeah, I think that is it. Yeah, for sure. That's totally it. All right. So let's commit this, eh? Oof, after I take a nice swig of coffee. Cool. And before I commit, I always like to just double check to make sure that I'm committing what I expect to be committing. And usually I just exit out of all the tabs and then I just go through them one by one. Alright, so first, what did we do here? We removed that stuff. So we removed the actual prop for that. Same deal here. Okay, that looks good. Playlist item. Remove that as well. Remove the delete action that we passed in. Show songlist action. Oh, I think this just... Oh, we deleted it from there as well. Okay, cool. And then same here. Just deleting the actions that we don't need any longer. Nice. Okay. And then swipeable playlist item. So. Again, deleting stuff. Deleting stuff. Cool. adding the pointed comments here. 900 pixels will give you the ability to add a comment in code. Cool. And so at this point in our songs list view, we're adding delete song from playlist action for Redux. And at this point, we are then deleting some stuff. Cool. Deleting some comments. Okay. And then we're going to do our delete song. And then we're actually going to call delete song from playlist. And the reason why we need this method is so we can actually delete the song through Redux. And then we have to refetch the songs after we delete them. So our component will update. Yeah, so we get new songs like that. So that looks good. And then down here, delete item by ID. I want to change that. Yes, so I want to do. So swipeable song item, I want to call this delete song. I guess we need to by ID, that's fine. Delete song by ID calls delete song. So delete by ID. Cool. Yeah, I really wanted to change that naming. I didn't like delete item. Cool. And then what else did we change? So we added a an action creator. So again, just pass in the type of action, the playlist ID, and the song ID. And then we had to map dispatch to the props. So when we call delete song from playlist, we are going to dispatch our action for that. Nice. Looking good there. Action types. Hey, Katoli, welcome back. Nice to see you, friend. Delete song from playlist. Just adding that const there. Action types. Playlist actions. I added spaces. Yes. And then we added our actual logic for deleting a song from playlist right there. And then the data reducer itself. Delete song from playlist. Delete song from playlist. Then we add our case where we return that. Heck yeah. Looking pretty good. I'm almost wondering. So I have playlist data reducer, and we have fetch mock data, add playlist, delete playlist. But then I have stuff for songs, like fetch songs, add song, delete song. They just come from a playlist. I think I should make another data reducer here. Right? Because... I feel like this is going to get really, really big. Because the other thing that I have to deal with is comments are a part of a song, but a song is a part of a playlist, so I would put the data reducer here, right? I feel like that should be changed. So I'll make one for playlists, I'll make one for songs, I'll make one for comments. It doesn't matter about the reducers, it'll probably just help it. It'll help maintain it better, right? So let's commit this, and then let's actually change it to utilize different reducers. And then like later on, if when we actually get real data coming in, if we need to do some other sort of logic, at least it'll be separate and commented out for each one of those sections. Yeah, that sounds like a good plan. Git commit, boom, baby. Adding, what's this thing called? Delete song from playlist redux action. Woo, let's go. I love it. I love it. We're hammering through this redux stuff. It's really, really nice. Okay, cool. So now for our reducer, we are going to create a new one called song. Probably songs data reducer, right? And now we should probably rename this thing too. From playlist to playlists. Right? Playlist data reducer? Let's close out all of these guys real quick. Yeah. So, I'm going to go here. Playlist data reducer. And then we're going to actually just change this to be playlists. And then we will do this guy here, replace all of those. And let's just make sure that builds first. Yeah, let's do an npm run start. Make sure the app still functions like that. Reload this guy. Cool. Got our playlist there. We can delete a playlist or delete a song. And then we can also delete a playlist. Nice. Perfect. Yo, K-Btix. Sorry if I butchered that. Thanks for being here. Welcome to the Pixlogic team. Hi. Thanks for the follow. Yo, Ryan. Yo, bro. You are a millionaire? What? Wow. Thank you. I hope to see $1 million in my bank account one day. When that day happens, you know what's up. Oh, are you a millionaire? Sorry, I didn't read that properly. I thought you said you are a millionaire. I'm like, damn, all right. I am not a millionaire, no. But thank you for the follow, Ryan. Welcome to the team. Glad to have you here. Hey, K-Merc, what's up? How far along are you in the app? Haven't watched in a while? So we are, I don't remember last time you here, but essentially we are at the point where we got a lot of the mock data in, but we have to actually switch our state management over to Redux to control a lot more, to have a better control of the better control of the state of the app. So we're implementing all that right now, but you can add songs, add playlists, add members, add comments as well, and you know, delete them and stuff. So this is all happening through mock data at the moment. So the next step is setting it up with server-side stuff. So still got a way to go. Disney World, here we come. Heck yeah, man. Let's get Grüvee to be a $1 million thing. I did a coding bootcamp and I had to defer to the next cohort because I was getting my ass whooped. Oh, really, Ryan? Hey, that's okay, man. It happens. It happens to the best of us. Programming's hard. Programming's not easy. What type of bootcamp stuff were you doing? So we can actually remove that. Add song to playlist. Delete playlist. Fetch songs. Delete song. Okay, cool. And then I'm going to delete these. Yeah, thanks, Merc. It's nice to see you back, dude. How's it been going? We're going to do initial state of songs. Full stack web development with an emphasis on JavaScript. Okay. Yeah, that's a pretty good thing to do. Definitely a hot tech right now. We're going to remove that stuff. And I'm actually going to move fetch to the top of this. So again, I'm making a new data reducer. Essentially, this will handle all of our logic and Redux implementation for song specifically, which is good, because I think we'll need that. Add playlist, no. Add song, yes. Okay. So at this point, we have fetch songs, which is really cool. We've already implemented it, so all of it's here. The only thing we need to do is now include it in our reducer mapper. So that's going to be import songs data reducer from songs data reducer. Yo, Egdonia, thank you so much for the follow. Welcome to the Pixelogic team. Glad to have you here, my friend. Cool. So now, literally, that is just in there. I think it should just work at this point, right? Songs again. Songs. Oh. I think this makes sense. Oh, you know what I'm thinking? So we have this initial state of this thing of songs. Wait, why is delete playlist in here? No. Leave. Delete playlist, get out of here. We don't need you. Yeah. Yeah, so at this point, what I'm thinking is we essentially could just be returning songs. The thing is that the songs are part of the playlist, so I feel as though it makes sense to return the playlist object, and then we just fetch our songs again at that point. But what we could also do is we could go into our songs list, playlist songs. So our song list view here. In our song list view, we map our props to the songs, and it makes sense. The reason why the component wasn't updating beforehand, and I had to call fetch, was because I'm not returning. Am I returning songs? I'm not. No. In my reducer, I'm not returning any songs. I'm just returning the playlist. Like the current state and then the playlist. Unlike here, I'm actually returning the songs. I'm not sure. Let's think about helping Alice Farmer remember JavaScript. Dude! We always need help! Yeah, and for anyone who's new here, this project is open source. You can actually find it right over here. And we've already had multiple requests come in, and we've completed those. So we'd love to have you contribute. This app is for all of us to build, not just me. So if you have any suggestions, any features, anything at all, get to that repo, make that PR, and let's do it. Yeah, I don't know why I'm feeling weird about this. I feel like in our songless view, like, I feel like if we have a songs data reducer, we should be returning songs, right? Like, our data reducer should always include a songs prop to it. And not necessarily just... Yeah, not just the playlist. Maybe we can do that. I think maybe that's something we should try. I think it's something we should potentially try. Kibtex, is React hard to grasp for relatively beginners? I think it all depends on your JavaScript knowledge. Because React obviously uses a lot of more advanced JavaScript / TypeScript implementations. So if you're kind of iffy on JavaScript in general, I think it will be harder to grasp, because React already uses kind of their own thing called JSX, which is essentially this stuff. It's a little different because it's React Native, but this like component sort of implementation syntax and just the way that these things work. It's not like it's basically like JavaScript embedded, interweaved with the way that they create views and things like that. But if you are fairly familiar with JavaScript, like, I don't think you'll have a problem. The hardest part is the components and like understanding how the state management works between all of these different components, and like one to create a proper component, and things like that. You know what? I'm not gonna do it. I need to research on this. I am not entirely sure. So I'm gonna put a to-do here, actually. Should this reducer just include, or always include, a songs prop when returning? I mean, essentially it will, because we're already spreading the current state, and so in this instance, playlist will come back, and then we'll have our current state, which has our songs. But the thing is, in the songs list, after we do something like a add or delete song, I'm calling fetch songs. And that's because the songs state is not being changed at all. It's just the playlist state. So if that's being changed, we're not getting the update here. But if I pass in a new songs prop, I believe that should trigger an update on the component. And we won't have to call this explicitly. So, yeah. But let's go ahead and see if this thing actually works now. And let me actually reload the bundler. Not hard if you're previous MVC framework knowledge. Definitely hard if you're coming from jQuery background. Yeah, that's some good thoughts there, technical. Hello? Yellow? What? Make sure package it is running. That was weird. Alright, so at this point, we should get our playlist. That looks good. Oh, here we go. Alright. Oh, I know why. Forgot to do one thing. So I... down here... when we do map state to props, the state is actually not coming from our playlist reducer, data reducer anymore. It's coming from our songs data reducer. And it's going to be dot songs. Yes. That would make sense. I'm going to wait for that to update. What? So it's not that? Hello? Yo-ho? Let me see if I missed a spot for my playlist. Playlist data reducer. Why am I using this thing as well? Oh, crap. I need to remove these. Holy moly. I didn't do it too well. So fetch mock data, add playlist, delete playlist, fetch songs. All of this can be removed. And then, yeah, let's, I totally forgot. I didn't clean this up. And then, at this point, I'm gonna do a quick search for playlists data reducer. Oh. Hey, Pippin Brock Andre, thank you so much for the follow. Welcome to the Pixelogic team, my friend. Glad to have you here. Heck yeah, dude. Okay, so this does look good. Looks like it's there. And then this is our index.js, which will be our combine. Let's look for combine reducers is right there. And so at this point, Redux provider, reducers.index. And so this right here, yeah, is where our reducers will live, right? When we create our store. So it should be implemented now. And the playlists work, which is good. But we still have this issue. Fetch songs from playlist. So playlist actions, 32. Let's see what we got. So it says, yeah, can't find property, cannot read property find of undefined. Oh, of current playlists. Ah. Fetch songs from playlist. So I can't find anything if we don't pass in the current playlist, which makes sense. Oh, So our initial state equals songs. Oh, a bazanga. Yeah, this is a. How do I get the playlist? Can I? How do I do that? How do I get the playlists here? Wonder if I can call. I can essentially do the same thing. So it wouldn't be. It would essentially be fetch playlists. So at this point, yeah, when we do our fetch mock data, we're just spreading that. But when we're trying to access the songs data reducers, I actually need to fetch my current playlists. And then I need to filter those out, right? Oh, unless I don't need to really do that. I could actually just do, yeah, songs list. Fetch songs will have a playlist ID. Oh, yeah, no, I do need to do that. I have to know. Yeah, I have to know what the or I need my playlist. I need to know the playlist, essentially. And at this point in our song data reducer, I don't have any playlists. Our state has nothing. So I feel at this point, our initial state for songs playlist should also be equal to like a fetch playlist or something like that, right? I don't even know how that would technically work. Yeah, this is actually kind of weird. Because again, when we do fetch mock data, it's essentially just our playlists, which is our current playlist state, and then mock playlist. Oh, but that's, no, this should work. Because at this point, oh no, I'm crazy. Yeah, this should technically work. Our state should have some playlists on it, because the first thing we do in Redux is we load up our playlist view, right? So let's print our state here, see what the heck is going on. So I believe at that point we should have our playlist. So I wonder why it's not coming back. Unless it's undefined for another reason. Doesn't seem correct to me though. Yeah, because so the first thing we do is fetch mock data, which has our playlists, right? Oh, but that's... Oh, is it because it's part of another data reducer? So I guess it's essentially I need to share data across reducers, is what it sounds like. That's why, dude. Oh, okay. So it'd be... Oh! Dude. I know exactly what we need to do. So our initial state should honestly just be playlists, and it should be, oh, but I don't have access to state, so no, shouldn't be anything. It should just be songs. And then at this point, it should be state dot playlists data reducer. Yeah, dot playlist. Reduver? No. Yes! Okay, now that makes sense. I think this should work. Can I get a first try, anyone? Hello? First try? A one time. Oh, is it gonna log? I wanna see my playlist. Oh no. Damn it! I really thought that was gonna work. I was so certain. Oh man. Hey Poopa! Reducer not back to other reducer states? Damn it! I thought that would have happened. So close. Hack. Anyway, it was a good attempt, but I didn't understand it, I guess. So then, what could I do here, Poopa? Essentially, I separated out my songs to be a different reducer, just because I felt like my playlist data reducer was going to get, like, freaking insane. Would I essentially have to do a... Yeah, is there a way to share it all? Oh, then dispatching data to reducer. Okay, that's what I thought. Yeah, so here's the thing. This playlist reducer, it was these three, plus 1, 2, 3, these three. And then I will have adding more to that, obviously. So this thing would have been like 12 to 15 different actions inside of this one reducer. And that just seemed like felt like I could separate that out more. Is that something that you've seen in practice? I'm not really quite sure. You can separate them? Should I separate them by a reducer, though, I guess is the question. Or should I do like... Or is it just separating files out? We need to manipulate data before dispatching to reducer. Gotcha. Okay, yeah, so then what would happen? Would shared initial state for both reducers work? What's up, Forsen? In theory, it sounds like it would work. In practice, I'm not sure if it's possible, as it sounds like you can't share this initial state. You can't share data between reducers unless you do it a certain way. They're intertwined. Yeah, you think so? It seemed like it made more sense to separate them, but I just would be user object and a place object. Gotcha. Okay. Yeah, that makes perfect sense. So I wonder if I can just do separate files, like playlist actions, song actions, and then just import them all in here. So it's not so like, duh, you know? You can separate them, but you should rely on thunk or pre-dispatch to manipulate data before dispatching to store. Okay. Yeah, because also what I could do, I could either separate them out like that, or in my song list view, before I dispatch like you're saying, I could actually... I would need to also get my playlists in here. Right? I'd need to fetch my playlists. Or I have my playlist ID. Okay. All right. Yeah, we should look at this. Yeah, we were talking about thunks yesterday as well. So yeah, we definitely should probably look into that. But I gotta take a quick pee. I will be right back, friends. And we will talk about thunks. Ayo! Sorry about that. What's up, Corsic? Welcome in, friend. Oh, you already have the middleware ready to go, so it'll be super simple to add Redux Thunk. Should be a one-liner. All right, let's take a look. Yeah, so I guess let's go ahead and do... I think Thunk stuff is definitely something that we will want to do. I guess the question is... Yeah, I guess let's look it up first. Redux Thunk. Why do I need this? Good question. With a plain basic Redux store, you can only do simple synchronous updates by dispatching an action. Middleware extend to store's abilities and let you write async logic that interacts with the store. Thunk's a recommended middleware for basic Redux side effects logic, including complex synchronous logic that needs access to the store and simple async logic like AJAX requests. So we will need that eventually anyways, considering that we will be making web calls, right? So Redux Thunk middleware allows you to write action creators that return a function instead of an action. The thunk can be used to delay the dispatch of an action or to dispatch only if a certain condition is met. Oh, that's actually pretty cool. The inner function receives the store methods dispatch and get state as parameters. Oh, nice. An action creator that returns a function performs to perform asynchronous dispatch. So for example, we have this action creator called increment. Increment async. Return dispatch. Set timeout. With dispatch, dispatch increment. Okay. An action creator that returns a function to perform conditional dispatch. So this is good that it returns dispatch and get state, because if we do get state, then we get the playlist, which means we can dispatch it, or we can, when we do a fetch for the songs, we can get the state of the current playlist. Or do whatever logic we need, right? And then we dispatch, like, fetch or whatever. Sweet. All right. Yeah, I think this will make sense. I would like to separate them out. It might be a little too granular, but I think it would be nice. They are connected in some way, songs and playlists, obviously, but there's different logic behind some of them, right? Hey, Bobek. Yeah, that's... I was talking to a friend about that the other day. He's like, dude, why don't you just use context? And the reason why we are using React Native is because of the React Native navigation. Yeah. Yep. And he's like, oh shit, I had no idea. And I'm like, yeah, man. It's annoying, but it happens. So. Alright. Redux Thunk, here we come. So we're going to install it. Then we're going to add it to our middleware. Redux provider? Yeah. We did go down this road. So most servers say assume that Redux Thunk 1x, so you might run into an issue when running their code. If you use Redux Thunk in context, don't forget to add .default to your import. Okay. Sounds good to me. We should do a middleware section. Middleware. Logger. Redux Thunk. Da-na-na-na-no. before import? Oh. Oh, yeah. Yeah, probably here, right? And then, oh, it's going to complain about this. All right. So we got our logger. We got our Redux thunk. Our middleware's in there now. And I guess we just try it out, eh? So I wanted to go and use this sort of example. And so if we go to our songs list, yo, long time ago, Alec, how you been? Hey, Demir, dude, I know, I remember you, man. It's been good. What's up? Welcome back. How do you set up so you have split window on integrated terminal? Oh yeah, so in VS Code, I'll pull this up for you. You actually have this little button here. And if you click it, you can do a split terminal like that. You can actually do many split terminals. Yeah. And then you can just remove them like that. Yeah, it's pretty great for instances like this when you want them integrated. So in our songs list, we will do, essentially we need to, fetch songs. Okay. So in fetch songs, we'll pass in a playlist ID and we'll need to pass in the playlist itself, right? So we need to actually return this method that has dispatch. Oh, yeah, dispatch and get state. That's what it was. And then at this point, we will do I put thunks in action files, by the way. Oh, gotcha. Oh, right. That's what we were talking about as well, to remove the logic, right? So in here, in my songs list, right, we can create something called, do you usually make like a, I guess per component, like an actions folder, and then you, or I guess just actions file in general, and then you just keep them. Sorry, I'm totally losing my train of thought. And then just import them like that. And so songlist will have one, essentially playlist item or playlists will have one as well, depending on your needs. Yeah, I think something like this probably do. I don't think I need to import anything from Redux, right? Should be pretty solid. Hey, the Snowforge, thank you so much for the follow. Appreciate you being here. Welcome to the Pixelogic team. Glad to have you. Oh, gotcha. Yeah, it's actually, it's a much better idea. I already have an actions folder, I believe, in my Redux somewhere. Yeah, here we go. Yeah, I literally created this thing already that does this thing. But so, you have defined action types on the component level, by the way. I would move those to action folders as well. I did this as part of Redux. So I have Redux and then I have an actions folder and I have actions type and playlist actions. Yeah. But these playlist actions are literally just like the logic for the action, right?
And so is this... Oh, you go to your component? Because at this point, we could end up just doing... Oh. These guys. Oh, sorry. These guys. Yeah, yeah. Okay, so this is what I was going to move, right? These are the action creators. And so these I move to the thunk, from what I'm understanding. All right, move to the this new actions thing here. So the first one I wanted to do was fetch songs. And so... Let's do a new folder. Actually, you don't need a new folder. Just do a file. .js. And then we can just do an export default, right? Okay. oh no, we would probably want to do export const fetch songs, right? Something like this. Pass in playlist ID, and then we would use this. And then that's going to give me crap about having that being the only one. I'm just going to put this here so it, it removes that error. Okay. So this thing here, then we can do a return dispatch get state. And then we get this thing. And then here, our action creator, we would, I don't know if we need the playlist ID since we have, oh, no, we do need the playlist ID. We just need to get the playlist as well. Or we just do that here. My thoughts, I think, are confused. So in the thunk, we have dispatch, we have get state. We're going to dispatch our fetch songs action. But what we can do Right. Okay, yeah, sorry. I think I was confused. What's up, Jay Louise? I'm using the Adam One Dark theme. Welcome in, by the way. You can dispatch multiple actions. Yes. Okay. So, and then in my songless view, I'm going to want to call the thunk. No. In the action, in the component, I'm going to want to call... I'm going to want to call the thunk. Or whatever. What, Adam and not Xcode? Oh, dude. Well, this is actually VS Code, and Xcode is more for Apple, iOS, and macOS development type stuff. You can still do, I guess, development in JavaScript, but like, nah. No way. Okay, so I'm thinking then what we can do is action creators, or I guess actions, and then we'll have thunks. And so at this point,
when we're ready to dispatch, then we'll dispatch the action, which will be const fetch songs. And then we'll, right now we'll pass in playlist ID. I don't know exactly what we're gonna need, because I think we can alter this logic a tad. We'll pass in our type. I need to import the stuff. These guys, yeah. No, not those guys. Oh no, yeah, those guys. Fetch songs. Data. Playlist ID. Okay. And then at this point, eventually, we would call dispatch fetch songs. Depending on what logic we want to do, right? Oh, but from what I read, I thought that, I mean, I was, oh, yeah, yeah, sure. So the way that this works right now is React Native actually, as long as you have Xcode installed on your machine, you get all the simulators along with it. So React Native actually just, you specify which iOS device you want to use and it'll pop up that device. But yeah, in that sense, yeah, I don't want to code in Xcode. WebStorm is dope. I use JetBrains. Got away from Microsoft. Okay, nice. Yeah, JetBrains is pretty great. I've never used WebStorm though. But yeah. How do you feel about Expo for Dev, a React Native? I actually haven't used it. So I'm not really sure, man. Not really sure. So I mean, technically, what we can do here. Let's do this. And then, yeah, the more you learn. Exactly, dude. Exactly. We're doing the same thing with Android Studio. As long as you have Android Studio installed, you get a bunch of different emulators. So I can launch the same app within an Android device as well. To get it up and running, noob friendly. Okay, nice. That's cool. Yeah, I've heard a lot of people use WebStorm, but yeah, VS. I used to use Atom. I loved Atom, and then one day on stream, people were like, "Yo, just switch to VS Code. Come on, man." And it's like, "Nah, I don't want to do it." And then I switched, and I'm like, "Never going back. Never going back to anything other than VS Code for like web development. Actually, most development I do through VS Code." Except iOS stuff, I do through Xcode. So at this point, the fetch songs. We have our fetch songs action. And right now, the only thing that our fetch songs action is doing. Is finding, getting the playlist. It gets the current playlist, and then it literally finds it by ID, and then the songs. So I guess it begs the question, do I just pass in the playlist along to that, or I just do the find here? I feel as though that's not really what the thunk is supposed to be used for. Yeah, gotta do more Xcode. Yeah, man, I'm working on a couple iOS projects right now. So I'll probably end up streaming some of them eventually. Yeah, if you're dispatching an action to a song store, I would handle playlist relay logic in the thunk. Yeah, so that's what I was thinking. So if I have playlists, the only thing I need to do, because Poopa, the only thing this is doing is literally finding the playlist and then returning the songs. So what would make sense, I believe, is to do this here. But then at the same time, the only other thing that this would end up doing is just returning songs, which I guess is, that's okay, right? Right? That makes sense. I haven't tried it, Partial. That's what this new project is. I have pretty much all the logic of the app set up. I just need to now actually implement SwiftUI. But I've heard good things. Oh, a lot of bugs? Oh, that's kind of crappy. Get set returns a reducer bucket. Oh, but it returns a reducer bucket. But if my get state, wouldn't it map to playlist? Right? Because my reducer bucket has a prop in there called playlist. So wouldn't it just automatically map to that? And so I wouldn't need to do that. So let's call this playlist. So get state returns state. State looks like state.playlistReducer.playlist. Oh, gotcha. So then at this point, can I just do state? And then I'll do. Wait, no. I was just following this thing here. This was saying, where is this get state counter? Gotcha. Okay. I wrote an Objective-C app and then Swift came out. Then I tried to get with Swift and then Swift changed version. So I was like, table flip over it. Oh, dude. Yeah, that was probably when Swift was like, dude, they were coming out with new, like, breaking changes all the time, and it was really annoying. It wasn't until around, like, Swift 3 when it started slowing down. Yeah, I started with Swift 2, and it was, like, every month something would come out, and I had to refactor all my code, and I'm like, bro, stop. But it's much more stable now. It's much more stable. It's a great language to work with, in my opinion. It has literally everything that you need. I think most of the time. I haven't done Swift in a little bit. Yeah. Okay, so get state again returns state that looks like state.playlistReducer.playlist. Okay. Yeah, if you create store with playlist reducer, song reducer. Looks like playlist, you would access playlist to get state, playlist, reducer, playlist. Yeah, okay. That's what I thought. So then, couldn't you do something like this? Can't you do playlist data reducer dot playlists? Right? Or is that, that's not considered? I thought there was something. Oh! Or it was like this. I don't remember what the syntax was. There's something like that. Yes. Yeah. Yes. Something like that, right? Yeah, you told me that the other day, I think. did I write the syntax incorrectly? Dude, I got you, man. Embedded. Oh, baby. Embed that code, boy. You have to deconstruct differently. Oh, or I can just do this. right? That could also be a thing. Oh, that's what it was. No, I want to do it that way. I learned it. I want to do it. Yes. Yes. Move. Yes, thank you, sir. That's what it was. Heck yeah. Bro, this is too fancy. This is way too fancy for me. It's like I almost know how to write JavaScript. Almost. So our playlist data reducer has a prop playlist. Get the state. Playlist.find. We find the playlist with the given ID. We dispatch that. That's going to move over to our playlist. Playlist action? Oh, this is going to need to be moved to the song actions. That's what it was. That's what it was. So add playlist action, add song to playlist. So this thing, we actually got to move. Y'all move them out to this guy. Oh, wait, what? Oh, no. That's not what I wanted. So at this point, when we do our dispatch, it's in our reducer, right? True, this thing. Yeah, this is where the fetch would get called at this point. And so actions plays a song actions. I feel like I should separate this out as well. Song actions, fetch playlist. Still take my breath when you don't realize. I try to take you back. Oops. Fires that we once set. I burn up all the hills. Oopsie. Playlist action, yeah, that was it. So then here, we'll just actually take in playlist. I'm just gonna be right. That was my only logic. Yeah. Playlist.songs. And so, if this isn't playlist actions, that's not a playlist action anymore. Song action. I just don't think. I don't think that it should be in here. Maybe another folder called like dispatch actions or like song dispatch actions. And then we'll have add song. Yeah, so we have all those there. So now the fetch songs should just take our action.data, which is the playlist. And then again, dispatch actions. Return playlist.songs. Because at that point, we are just literally returning this current state with the songs included as its own prop. Yeah. Okay. I think this is good. I think this is good. And then we can, did I remove these down here yet? Fetch songs we can remove. And then we'll have to import those. And so that's gonna come from this stuff now, which should be import. Fetch songs from song actions. From, let's do Grüvee Redux actions songs actions songs songs actions. So fetch songs then shall come down here. Fetch songs will be that. And then we don't need anything. We do. We still need the playlist ID. We still need the playlist ID to find our stuff. Heck yeah. Okay. So our fetch should technically work, right? Should it? This hat's gonna be like that. Oh. Fetch songs. Oh, we'll do. Oh, gotcha. Yeah, that's fine. Okay. I don't know if it's going to work first try, but let's compile it and see. There's always a chance. You never know. And then I do have to go. Let's try it again. Man, what an intense session of Redux. Holy bejesus. So right now, the playlist stuff should work as expected. It's the songs that we're hoping to work. So we got that. You see our actions called. What? First try? Hello? Hey, there we go. Received? Oh, but I called it twice. Oh. Because I have it wrapped in dispatch. Yo, oh my god, I think it worked. First try. I think it worked first try. Dude, such a rare occurrence. It should be wrapped in dispatch? Why? Because isn't it? It's getting dispatched here. Right? Because like, Biako, what's up, friend? Welcome in. Dude, it's been a freaking while. It's been a while.
Let's get out of this town. The
Dude, doing well, man. Doing well. I'm unfortunately about to head out in a little bit. Unfortunately. But I appreciate you coming by here, man. What's going on with you? So, okay, yeah. So you're saying you are supposed to... Oh, no, but this is in the thunk. Or this is... No. Because it just called it twice. If I'm not mistaken. Oh. Oh, is it because the first one? Oh, I think I see. I think I see. So the way that the thunk is working is in order for the dispatch to even happen to begin with, it's still calling. Actually, hold on. Hold on. Dude, we're working on an app called Grüvee. It's been fun. It's using React Native for iOS and Android. The log statements help me out a lot. So the first action that's received is the thunk, right? Which is this thing. And then once the logic for that goes through, then it calls the fetch songs. Yes. Okay, that makes sense. So this would be the first one, right? And then this would be the second one. Yeesh. Okay. So it worked. It's actually pretty cool. It's actually pretty cool, man. Yeah, definitely. I'm gonna put that as a comment and make sure we go back to that. All right, folks. Woo! Yo. Today was a good stream. Felt very productive. Man, what? What a time. Thank you for the help, Poopa. Appreciate it, man. Like always, dude. I feel like I'm learning so much from you. I really appreciate it. Still Spotify app? Yeah, very similar. I think that's the one you were probably here for that we talked about. Yeah, it's that one.
It is the one.
But okay, let's get back to this guy over here and let's log what we need to do. So added new actions for deleting song. Add a new action for delete song and started to implement funks. Still in the process of setting up that hierarchy, but we'll finish next stream. We also need to make sure to ignore functions in the logger so it doesn't print them out. All right, heck yeah, dude. Friends, again, it's been a fun time. Thank you all for being here today. Listen, if you're new to the channel, consider giving it a follow. We'd love to have you back. We'd love to get notified when I go live. I'm here. Today's the fourth day streak. I'm trying to do every day. But currently, the stream is set up to be Monday through Friday, 5:30 a.m., PST or 12:30 p.m. UTC. Yeah, follow the channel. Get notified. And also check out the Discord and Instagram. We got a lot of places to hang out outside of the stream. Yeah, would love to have you there. Instagram, I post my daily life, software engineer at a tech company. As well as just some fun stuff throughout the day and some thoughts. And Discord, we have a bunch of people over there talking, hanging out, showcasing projects, helping each other with anything that's needed. And yeah, would love to have all of you a part of the communities. as we try to grow this stream, man. Yo, Jack Mark and Raleo, thank you so much for the follows, friends. Welcome to the Pixlogic team. Very happy to have you here. And folks, at the end of every stream, we always throw a nice, tasty raid. So if you are a sub, grab that first message, Adalam Pog, let's get groovy. And if you're not, no worries. Grab the second one, Twitch raid, let's get groovy. We about to get groovy. We about to get groovy. Yo, Code Phobia is on right now. He's raided us twice today with 30 plus viewers. Let's show him some love. But guys, it's gotta be big. It's gotta be a wild raid, alright? It's gotta be a wild raid. Oh no! Did he leave? Is he leaving? No. Or maybe he's just BRB. Appreciate you all being here, friends. Let's show Code Phobia some awesome love. Have a great rest of your day, and I will see you right back here, same time, same place tomorrow. Peace and love, friends.